Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. Welcome to online classes. This side Khushbu Rizwani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. Students, today I am here to teach you EVS. We are going to revise chapter number 10, means of transportation, and chapter number 11, safety rules. First we will revise chapter number 10, means of transportation. Let's see. In this chapter we are going to revise what is transportation, what are means of transport and modes of transport. Transportation means we travel and carry goods on land, on water and in air. It is transportation. Now, means of transport. Children, you know we cannot go everywhere on foot, so we take some or the other conveyance to travel. Some people travel by car, bus, train or train. Some people travel by boats and ships. Some people travel by aeroplanes and helicopter. All these are the means of transport. You know, by means of transport our life has become very easier. Now we will study modes of transport. There are three modes of transport: land transport, water transport and air transport. Now we will study first land transport. Land transport means vehicles that run on land and on rails, such as car, bus. These vehicles run on land. Some are fast and some are slow. Vehicles such as tonga and balgadi, they are slow. You know why they are slow? Because they are driven by animals. Vehicles that run on fuel are fast. Train runs on railway tracks. And you know, metro is a special train. Why it is a special train? First of all, it is very fast, and second thing, it runs on the ground and under the ground. Now, road signs. Children, when we are traveling on road in a vehicle, we should always follow road signs. First, we should cross the road on zebra crossing. Second thing, we should first look to the right, then to the left, and then to the right while crossing the road. If there is no vehicle or vehicle very far away, then only we should cross the road. We should follow traffic rules also and road signs, such as no parking, speed breaker ahead, school ahead, no right turn, no horn and many more. We should follow all these road signs. Next is water transport. We travel goods from one place to another through water transport. Water transport is one of the oldest means of transport. Boats and ship dock at the port. Boats cover short distances and ships cover large distances. Who sails a boat? Sailor. Next is air transport. Air transport is the means of transport which flies in the air. Aeroplane is the fastest means of transport. We can cover very long distances in a very short period of time. Do you know who flies an aeroplane? Pilot flies an aeroplane. Now children, I hope you must have revised this chapter with me. Now we will revise book work of this chapter. First is match the following: train, metro, ship and aeroplane. Very large boats takes off and lands at an airport, runs on railway tracks and special train. First, train. Train runs on, I explained you na, train runs on which track? No, it runs on railway tracks. So we will write number one over here. Next is metro. Which train is a special train? It's metro. So in special train, answer is special train. Number three, ship. Now, boats are small boat and ships are very large boats. Very large boats are called ships. So, very large boat is the answer. Aeroplane. Now, children, you know where ship and boats dock? They dock at port. Next, where train stops? It stops at railway station. The same way, aeroplane takes off and lands at an airport. So, the answer is takes off and lands at an airport. I hope you must have revised this question with me. Now question number B. paste pictures of various means of transport using the clues given below. It is slow. Which vehicle is slow? After walking, which vehicle we use which is very slow? I explained you na, on land transport some are very slow, some are very fast. So bicycle is slow. It gives out smoke. Which vehicle gives out smoke, children? Car. So answer is car. It has wings. Which vehicle has wings like birds? Aeroplane. Answer is aeroplane. It sails. Which vehicle sails? Ship, boat. So the answer is boat. Okay children, now we will revise notebook work of this chapter. What are the three means of transport? What are the three means of transport? The three means of transport are land transport, water transport and air transport. Children, what are the three means of transport? First is land transport, second is water transport and third is air transport. Write any two names of each. Now we have to write two names, two example of each transport. First is land transport. Land transport means vehicle that runs on land and on rails. Let's see the example. First is car, second is bus. Question number 2, water transport. Now we will write two examples of water transport. Boat, ship. 3, air transport. Two examples of air transport. Aeroplane, helicopter. Children, now we will revise spellings of this chapter. Okay, first is TRAIN, train. Second is metro, METRO, metro. Which train is a special train? Metro. Third is aeroplane, AEROPLANE, aeroplane. Fourth is helicopter, HELICOPTER, helicopter. I hope you must have revised these spellings with me. I hope children you must have revised chapter number 10 properly with me. Now we will revise chapter number 11, that is safety rules. In this chapter we are going to revise what is safety, how to be safe at home, how to be safe at school, how to be safe on the road, how to be safe in the park and swimming pool. First of all, I will tell you what is safety. Protecting oneself from any harm is called safety. Now, safety rules at home. Children, some points how to be safe at home. You love playing, you play hide and seek. One thing you should keep in your mind that you should not hide inside the cupboard. Because if any time your cupboard will be locked, you will not be able to breathe and you may be not safe. So you should never hide inside the cupboard. Second, you should not touch any sharp things like blades, knives and scissors. Number 3, when your hands are wet and you are bare feet, you should not touch any electric objects. Fourth, you should not eat medicine on your own. Now we will revise safety rules at school. Children, do not jump on desks and chairs, do not run on staircase, do not push or pull each other, and most important thing, when you are outside the school, you should not talk to any strangers. Now you know who are strangers? Strangers are the unknown person, the person whom you don't know. Next is safety rules on the road. Children, you know road is a very busy place because many vehicles move on the road, like car, bus, motorbikes and many more. You should not stand in the middle of the road, you should not play on the road, you should not run on the road. And when you are walking on the road, you should walk on the footpath. Now you know what is footpath? Footpath is a path on the side of the road. You should cross the road on zebra crossing. When you are crossing the road, first you should look to the right, then to the left and then to the right again. And if there is no vehicle or vehicle very far away, then you should cross the road. Now, if you are driving a vehicle, you should also follow traffic signals. Traffic signals are three: red light, yellow light, and green light. Red light says stop, yellow light says get ready, and green light says go. Next is safety rules in the park and in the swimming pool. Children, I know whenever you go to the park, you get so much excited that you push or pull each other. But you should not do this thing. You should never push or pull each other because you may get hurt, you may get injured. You should not do doubles on swings. You should wait for your turn. You should never tease stray animals, and you should not talk to strangers in the park also. And if they try to give you something, you should say no to them, and you should tell your parents about them. Next is in the swimming pool. You should not enter the swimming pool alone. Second thing, whenever you are entering the pool, you should always wear life jacket because it protects you from drowning. Now, beside these things, children, you should be safe. You should be safe everywhere. You should follow safety rules everywhere. I hope you must have revised this chapter with me. Now, we will revise book work of this chapter. Let's see. Do not touch sharp objects like dash. What are the sharp objects? Blades, knives, and scissors. So we will write scissors over here. S-C-I-S-S-O-R-S. Dash appliances can burn your hand. Which appliances can burn your hand? When your hands are wet and you are barefoot, if you will touch these appliances, it may you may get burned. So answer is electrical. E-L-E-C-T-R-I-C-A-L. Do not talk to dash outside the school. Whom you should not talk outside the school? You should not talk to strangers. So the answer is strangers. Do not walk in the dash of the road. Where we should not walk? We should not walk in the middle of the road. Answer is middle. Do not push to get inside the dash. Children, when you are going to school, when you are going into the bus, you should not push each other. You should stand in a queue to get into the bus. So the answer is bus. Do not tease dash animals. Which animals you should not tease? You should not tease stray animals. I hope you have revised book work with me. Children, now we will revise notebook work of this chapter. Let's see. Question first, write down one safety rule to be followed at home. Answer is, we should not play with sharp objects like scissors. I told you na, we should not play with sharp objects. Sharp objects like blades, knives, and scissors. We have to tell one thing, so we have written scissors over here. Question number two, write down one safety rule to be followed at school. Now, how to be safe at school? Let's see. We should not jump on desks and chairs in the classroom. Children, you should not jump on desks and chairs in the classroom. You know why? Because if you will fall, you may get hurt or you may get injured. So, you should not jump on desks and chairs. Question 3. What will happen if you follow safety rules? Now, what will happen if we will follow all the safety rules? If we follow safety rules, we can avoid accidents. If we will follow all the safety rules, we will avoid what? We will avoid accidents. We will be safe. Children, now we will revise hard words of this chapter. Let's see. First is scissors. S-C-I-S-S-O-R-S. Scissors. Second is electrical. E-L-E-C-T-R-I-C-A-L. Electrical. Third is M-I-D-D-L-E. Middle. Fourth is I-R-O-N. Iron. Fifth is S-T-R-A-Y. Stray. Children, I hope you have revised these words with me. Children, after revising both the chapters, now we are going to revise worksheet of these chapters. Let's see. Question first. Who flies an aeroplane? Pilot or driver? Who flies an aeroplane? Pilot. Answer is option A, a pilot. Do not dash in deep water alone. In deep water alone, we should not do? We should not swim. Option number A. An aeroplane takes off and lands at an dash. Where aeroplane takes off and lands? Option A, railway station, or option B, airport? Answer is option number B, airport. Fourth, we should walk on the dash, road or footpath. Where we should walk? Road is a busy place, so we should always walk on the footpath. Correct answer is option number B, footpath. Fifth, and dash helps us to travel fast. Which vehicles help us to travel fast, kids? Option number A, car, or option number B, aeroplane? Option number B, aeroplane, because by aeroplane we can cover long distances in very short period of time. Point number 6, wear a seat belt in a dash. Option A, car, option B, bicycle. Children, in bicycle do we have seat belt? No. When we are traveling in a car, we should always wear a seat belt. So option number A, car, is the correct answer. We should wear dash in a boat. What we should wear in a boat? When we are traveling in a boat, when we are going to somewhere in a boat, what we should wear? Option number A, helmet, or option number B, life jacket? Correct answer is option number B, life jacket, because it protects us from drowning. Question number 2, match ups. Red light, green light, we cross the road, and ship. Sailor on the zebra crossing, go and stop. Red light. Red light says stop. Option number D. Green light. Green light says go. Option number C. We cross the road. How we cross the road? On the zebra crossing. Ship. Now who sails ship? Sailor. The way who flies an aeroplane? Pilot. Question number 3. State T for true and F for false. First, do not eat any medicine on your own. Children, you are too small and you should not eat medicine on your own. I told you, how to be safe at home. You should not eat any medicine on your own. So this statement is true. We will write T over here. Question number 2. Do not hide inside the cupboard when you play. I told you, if you will hide inside the cupboard, your cupboard may be locked, you will not be able to breathe, you may hurt yourself, you may get injured. So this statement is also true. We will write T over here. Question 3. You should play in the garden after it is dark. Children, you should not play in the garden after it's dark, because so many strangers come in the garden and your parents care for you. So you should reach home on time. So this statement is false, because it says that you should play in the garden when it's dark, but you should come to home before it's dark. Now I hope you must have revised both the chapters and worksheet with me properly. Keep learning, keep revising. Thank you.